did a lot this semester. Okay, now you need probably scratch paper to figure out how to factor each of these. And again, any method you want to use will be fine as long as you're sure you factor correctly, which you know whether you factor correctly by multiplying it back out. All right, so that's the first thing we need to do for both of these. You cannot cancel until it's both the numerator and denominator factored. So this is 3x, and that's x. And you know this is going to be a 2x and an x. Almost done. All right, with multiplication and division, you still need to have everything factored before you can cancel. With division, you're going to have to multiply by the reciprocal first. All right, so on this first problem, just remember all of these things need to be factored if possible. So x minus 3 can't do anything more with that. But out of 8x plus 2, you could take a 2 out, so that's a factor, and 4x plus 1. And let's see, out of the denominator, you could factor out an x, and that gives you 4x plus 1. And x squared minus 9 is the difference of 2 squares, x plus 3 and x minus 3. So you have to go through all that, and now see if there's some common factors. So the x minus 3 cancels with that x minus 3. The 4x plus 1 cancels with that 4x plus 1. So I'm left with a 2 at the top. There we go. It should be an x. And there we go. Okay, now the first thing you do over on this left side is multiply by the reciprocal. So I have x squared minus 2x over 15 times the 5x over x minus 2. And now we proceed by factoring just like we did on the left side. So these are factors, right? Now, if you want, you can cancel that 5 and 15 right now, or we can do it later. So I'm going to factor the x out of the x squared minus 2x. And I'm going to write this as times 5 times x, just so it's easy to see all the separate factors. And I'm going to write the 15 as 3 times 5. You could leave it as 15 and cancel and get the same thing. And now I see what I can cancel. X minus 2's go. And the 5's go. And so what I have left in the top is an x times an x. X squared. And the denominator, all I have is a 3. So I have x squared over 3. By the way, for part A, if you want, you could multiply the denominator out and leave it as x squared plus 3x. That's also fine. Okay? Either way, it's correct. Okay, we're adding. Now, we can only add if we have a common denominator, and luckily, in A and B, we've got common denominators. So we can just add the numerators. So we have 4x plus 5 added to 8x plus 5. And the denominator is just stays the same. You do not add the denominators. So that gives me 12x plus 10 over 6x plus 5. And no, you cannot cancel the 10 and the 5 or the 6x and the 12x. You have to factor. All right, so I could factor a 2 out of the top, and that's a 6x plus 5. And I can't factor out of the bottom, but how convenient. 6x plus 5's cancel, and so my answer is just the number 2. All right, let's go to the second one. This is a little bit trickier because of the minus sign here. You're going to have to subtract the whole numerator here. So, be careful. You've got x squared plus 3x minus an x squared minus 12. All over, you just write the denominator down. Do not add the denominators. So, I have x squared plus 3x minus x squared plus 12, because you have to distribute that minus sign. Well, now, in the numerator, the x squared minus x squared, that's gone, so I have 3x plus 12 over x squared plus x minus 12. Now we need to factor. So out of the top, you can factor out a 3, and at the bottom, you're going to have an x plus 4 times an x minus 3, and the x plus 4s are going to cancel. So when all is said and done, you're going to get 3 over x minus 3. So I'm going to write 3 over x minus 3. And you cannot cancel those 3s. Leave it be. Okay. Almost done.